il rosso nel
mondo. In the world of cars, the red color has always been intertwined with Italy, historically since the times when racing cars were painted red. It's the color of dream sports cars. It calls to mind the performance of their engines, and it is also the first color that springs to mind when thinking about brakes. And in this field too, Italy is a global point of reference. What you see behind me is the famous red kilometer, the place where the brakes installed on supercars are manufactured. Welcome to Brembo, where we do not only, let's say, supply braking systems to the most important car makers in the market. Behind the brake discs and calipers of the Bergamo-based company, there is a collaboration at engineering level with the automobile industry, starting from the very first design phases, continuing with development, and which is implemented when all the involved materials are manufactured, from cast iron to aluminum. The process starts with the transformation of raw materials and, consequently, with the production of the metal alloy that the components absorbing most of the braking energy are made up of. The Mapello plant is where the cast iron fusing process takes place, and consequently where discs are manufactured. Average fusion temperatures for cast iron reach approximately 1,150 degrees Celsius, with carbon percentages at around 4%.
Quelle migliori sono fisse.
The best ones are fixed, but actually, depending on the car, they are installed in different positions. Obviously, I am talking about calipers. The fusing, processing, and painting processing, which today are of considerable importance, also in the aesthetics customization of sports cars and supercars, where these braking systems are installed, are implemented in the Brembo plants and finished in the historic factory in Curno. Here, aluminum calipers are processed with numerical control machines, and the installation phases are completed, with an entire department totally dedicated to paint robots able to handle all the colors available in the market at present. After being manufactured, calipers and discs are moved to the area testing department. For example, a test bed for all the materials that will have to ensure the best performances of the brakes under any conditions. In these corridors, engineers and specialized technicians verify the static limits of mechanical strength through tests that involve the use of cyclic loading without moving parts, as well as dynamic ones with tests that can involve the whole braking system or a single component, even on the stands where suspensions are installed too. In this area, the components undergo what is defined in mechanical engineering as fading, namely tests the goal of which is to verify the resistance to cyclic repeated limit stresses, which are higher to those that the brakes will have to endure during the vehicle's real use. When dealing with brakes, one thing is taken for granted, and it is taken for granted because when everything works well, we don't hear it. Let me explain why. I'm referring to when brakes start to be noisy. Industry experts call them whistles, and to tackle them, the Brembo specialists' work is based on a complex and well-structured methodology. They start with a virtual simulation. Then they proceed with test benches on components installed with the suspension unit, which can generally contribute to the whistling because of what is technically defined as proper resonances. At this point, the verification is completed by driving on public roads, with models disguised to some extent, depending on the development stage of the cars that will be marketed with Brembo brakes. Test drivers make brake cycles on prototypes with installed microphones, accelerometers, and sensors able to acquire parameters such as the operating temperatures of different system components. pressure, speeds, and car accelerations. And then there's the subjective evaluation by testers who assess the braking system's behavior through the feeling they get from touching the brake pedal. And speaking of performances, this is how it works. In a first phase, the car manufacturer supplies the objective parameters that then get worked in all that which is the virtual trial in calculated simulation to then arrive at the true and proper physical tests with the automobile manufacturers on their test circuits like Nardo, Balocco, or even Fiorano, speaking of Italy, speaking instead of the maximum level of performance that Brembo can guarantee. The technology that makes the difference is that of carbon ceramic brakes. Specific quantities of carbon fiber and other raw materials are mixed and poured into aluminum molds, the size of which depends on the shape and dimensions of the different end products. The material polymerizes in heat presses. The molds are cooled down to move to the following stage, where the molds are opened. Computer-guided machines smooth out the rough area, carry out quality and dimensional controls, and then they drill ventilation holes. At this point, during the first thermal stage, the organic compounds are completely carbonized, while at the following stage, carbon is transformed into the real carbon ceramic material. Then, the compound goes through a third thermal stage, called antioxidation, which serves to shield the carbon fiber during vehicle use. And the final shapes and dimensions are obtained by means of mechanical processing, through the use of numerical control machines and high-resistance diamond tools, which can process the hardness of silicon carbide, from which the discs are made up of. Then, the discs undergo a microstructural 100% control aimed at identifying potential surface defects, and all the components are finally assembled. This is a state-of-the-art process, where all processing stages are constantly improved. It is a practical implementation of the so-called 4.0 industry, where automation meets the combination of the different processing stages to optimize the manufacturing of both discs and calipers. From raw materials to road tests, passing by the design of all components and keeping even production inside the company is how Brembo has basically become a synonym of the word brake everywhere in the world, and is also a symbol of the made in Italy.